like I can see pretty quickly I have issues on this line, so.
So you're actually changing those yourself.
Right.
Manually, rather than letting the code do it.
Right. So like if you mouse over the dot, that's gonna pull up a list of the errors. So on this line, I have 21 errors. Holy cow. So you can go through and fix them, right? I don't have my spaces, I don't have that. This doesn't need to be on the same line. I have another issue here. Let's see what that is. Oh, line didn't integrate, so that's not supposed to be embedded. Right, so I mean, it's all these little things. It is kind of tedious, right? That's where the PHPCS comes in. You can fix all these things. Hopefully, you're not running this on a big old file. If that's the case, then you do want to use the unifier. As you're coding, you know, the dot will pop up and you go, oh, I did something wrong. What did I do? Oh, there it is. I fixed it. Okay. In this case, it would get super tedious to go through and fix all these things one by one. So I'm not going to do all that today. Just show you, that's kind of how you see there's still an issue here. I don't know what it is. I don't see it immediately. Does anybody see what the issue is on this one? On this line?
Space after it.
Yeah, see? That's the beauty of tools like this, right? Because my human eye, I'm not going to see all the little nitpicky things, but this is going to find it for me and make it so much easier to adhere to these standards so that. Even though I'm imperfect, right, the tools help to make the code better and more sustainable in the long run. So that is the demo. Oh, one more thing. So within your project, you have this XML file. It's called phpcs.xml.dist. And what this does is this defines the standards or the rules that you want to use. So just because we have WPCS installed on our system, that doesn't mean we're necessarily using those rules. So this tells us, if we scroll down, so config, minimum supported WP version is 4.5, rule set is WordPress. So that's telling PHPCS, I want to use the WordPress rule set as your step in this, right? And you can define all sorts of rules. So there's some coding standard rules that might conflict with what you're doing and for various reasons. And so you can actually turn off some of the standards, some of the specific rules. And that's what you can, like some of these down here are. And I've got them commented out because I didn't want to mess with those. But like, so you want to prefix all the locals, for example. So any kind of global variable, you want to prefix that with the slug of your plugin or your theme so that it doesn't conflict with another plugin or another theme that might have the same thing. Things like that. So, but you can set those rules and set specific details of those rules as well. So that's what that file is for as well. Let me see. Let's get back into our slideshow here. I think that's all I got. Yeah, that's all I got. So any questions, comments? Criticism, compliments. Why are you looking handsome today? And also, this is my Twitter. If you want to ask questions on Twitter, later. Yes.
I had a question about using shorthand. I remember at the beginning of the talk, you said don't do like just a question mark. Mm-hmm. Is that also true for if you want to do the echo short code, or it's just like question mark?
Yes, don't do that. Right. If you want to hear the coding standards, don't do that. Right. You can do that. Obviously, it's especially from custom fields, because the end user is inputting those fields on the back end, right? And so some admin who's got a grudge against their boss says, I'm going to go run this site, they go and put all these, you know, hack JavaScript codes in there with custom fields. Well, you've got to escape all that before it actually gets to the end user on the front end, right? So
are you positive for ACF? I thought that's all validated. Yeah. I think that's all validated on the back end.
I'm certain that it is, right. But I mean,
yeah.
Again, I mean, ACF is a well-coded tool, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But I mean, in general, though, the rule is you should escape everything as late as possible, right? So as late as possible, being like when you're echoing out to the end users, you need to escape it at that point. Again, that's an annoying thing to have to put escape HTML on every little thing, but it's ultimately it's better for the end user, it's better practice to do that.
I guess you can do it like in the variable definition too, if you don't want to like pollute your form
definition,
right?
No.
No, yeah.
You do it like
the
measure. That's the as late as possible rule. Oh, I don't think it's okay. Gonna be in the echo, unfortunately, right? It's kind of because I agree with you, right? Like I would rather get all that ugly stuff out of the way when people see it, but it's ultimately it's better and more secure for the end user. Even though it doesn't make sense, like when you're doing it, you have to think in terms of like down the road. If you're not the one, because you're going to do it right and you're not going to put anything bad in there, but if someone else is managing the code down the road, you want to make sure that everything's escaped properly before facing the end user. So.
Well, and just a point of clarification on that too. One thing, you know, if you're pre-escaping a variable and then it goes through any other functions, there's a possible, injection at that point. Mm-hmm. And so that's why you want it as late as possible.
Right. Especially, so like in WordPress, I mean, apply filters, right? I mean, if any kind of filters are ever applied to anything, then you don't know what third-party plugin is going to grab, add that filter, change that variable. Somewhere between advanced custom fields and when you get a hold of it, there's a filter happening that might be changing it, putting some kind of hacks in there. Yeah, you're absolutely right. Yes?
Is there a way to just install PHP Code Sniffer and even the coding standards, like load the machine and just access that for each project instead of having like a composer config file for each workspace?
You can do that. You do need to have, whenever you run it, you've got to tell it which standard you want to use. And so that's where that's where this XML file comes in. That's where within your project, you've got to have something like this to tell PHPCS which standard you're using. Or within the command, if you run it on the command line, you use PHPCS dash dash standard equals WordPress. And as long as WPCS is installed, it'll use the WordPress standard when it's sniffing your code. But just in general, like it's better to kind of encapsulate it within a project because you're sharing the project, you know, either with other developers within your team or if it's like an open source project, you're sharing it globally. So you wanna have these things defined anyway in Composer and like the JSON file. So, but to answer your question, yes, it is possible to do that. This is just kind of like more of a standard way to do it. It's probably better for distributed code. Any other questions? We have 6 minutes.
So one more.
Yeah.
About like Blair mentioned the formatting on save, like prettier is the piece for JavaScript block, but like you can install, like have a coding standard or some kind of reference setup and then format, you can write everything in one line and just does it on save. So like all those little spaces and whatnot.
tools are there to kind of keep you honest, and also there to help if you're taking over a new project or what I mean. So one thing I'll point out actually that I meant to mention is there are ways to implement this within like continuous integration tools, like just like CircleCI, for example. Let me see if I have the So this is a CircleCI configuration. You can do it where it will install. If your composer file has the dependencies there, it'll run your PHPCS for you. So we have that on a lot of our projects where when we submit anything to GitHub, it's automatically going to run through CircleCI or CircleCI's tools and do any kind of linting in that PHPCS for us. So that's what I meant to mention earlier.
That last XML file, when you ran the composer install, was that generated by some of those dependencies that you had, or did you create that?
Yeah. So it's pulling in my project, and it's pulling in like this composer JSON file. And so when you run composer install, the composer.json file is what's telling it what dependencies it need to be there.
Right. But the phpcs.xml like this is that was that created because of did you pull in like the WordPress coding standard, or did you have to create that file?
So I had to create that file. Okay. Yeah. So that's an established standard. And another thing, and I don't know if this is a full-on WordPress standard, it's just a VIP standard, but like if you're doing like a comment like this, a regular like inline comment like this, you gotta put a period at the end of it. It's gonna be like a sentence. That might just be a VIP thing, actually. I'll have to look. I'm just used to having to do it, so it's. But just in general, like for my personal preference, comment the heck out of everything. Like, don't worry about making your PHP file small, because that's not gonna affect anything, right? So be as verbose, and you know what I mean? Like, be very descriptive and comment everything. Think about the next person. So I think we're out of time, actually. So I'm happy to hang out here if you guys want to ask more questions or talk about softball or do one or whatever else. So thank you so much for your time.